Now 602 happening today, expanding about a 5-mile stretch of I-94. We'll be at the center of a Milwaukee County Board of Supervisors meeting this morning. So members will vote again on whether to try and put the brakes on this proposed billion-dollar expansion of I-94 between the Marquette and Zoo interchanges.
This debate has been going on for years. Originally, the Wisconsin Department of Transportation, the Federal Highway Administration, were expected to approve these plans by the end of this year, but the DOT has now pushed that date back to next year so that officials have more time to review the plans. Ryan Jenkins is live this morning. He's got more on this still heated debate, Ryan.
Yeah, good morning. The idea is to expand the stretch of road between 16th and 70th streets. If you're familiar with this area, you probably know that there are often traffic jams here and there are often crashes in this area as well. But most of the Milwaukee County Board of Supervisors have made it clear that they do not support the plans to update this stretch of freeway, and they plan to double down on that message during their meeting today. In total, this project would cost about $1 billion. Less than 5 miles of highway would be expanded in both directions, but there are civil rights groups and Milwaukee leaders that have been pressuring the state to conduct more studies and the federal government to reject the plans altogether. The city of Milwaukee's Common Council earlier this year signaled that they do not support this project, and in a resolution that passed by the county board earlier this year, 16 of 17 board members signaled that the project should be thrown out, but their vote was then vetoed by County Executive David Crowley. Now, the goal today is to override that veto. A resolution, another one set to be discussed at today's meeting, reaffirms the board's opposition, suggesting that the pandemic may have changed the way that people work, therefore less people may be commuting as work from home becomes more normal. And another big concern is the noise and the pollution that this project could create. The resolution says that the project expanding the interstate is like, quote, loosening a belt to solve obesity, end quote. And they say it could allow for the same traffic jams on just a wider highway. Now, there is some data, if we follow that data, that shows that this stretch of highway has a higher crash rate, 2.5 times higher than similar highways in the state. The board, though, believes that there are better ways to spend this money to solve these issues. We'll talk more about those other ideas coming up in our next half hour. But for now, reporting live along I-94 in Milwaukee, Ryan Jenkins, TMJ4 News.
A lot of information there, Ryan. Thank you. At 6:05, going in greater depth, I-94 stretches nearly 350 miles across the state of Wisconsin. It was the first section of the interstate highway system completed within our state. A long time ago, construction began in 1956. The oldest stretch of this freeway is between exit 297 at Kirky's Corners and exit 290 just west of Waukesha. The 31-mile stretch between the Mitchell Interchange and the Illinois state line, that's been under construction, rebuild there since 2009.